So I'm going to start off by calling out Valerie, who in her great participation on the panel on capacity crisis, and tell her that in fact there is a beacon for mental health. So I guess I get to benefit from coming in the afternoon after hearing from a whole host of people that have a lot to say about mental health and have shared a lot of the statistics. I think what we can all agree is that the problem is huge and that there are huge barriers to solving the problem. And to give you a little bit of background, Sam and I and a few other investors, motivated investors, got into this area of mental health, which is not in our professional background, about 5 years ago. And we began that journey by partnering with CBT Associates, the clinical group that Sam referenced earlier. The reason why we were attracted to them is because they were focused and doing evidence-based therapy for mental health issues. And that was something that we thought was very, very important. Of course, their primary focus was on cognitive behavioral therapy, something that we were familiar with. If you're not familiar with as a non-clinician, I will describe it as a protocol-driven course of treatment that's focused on skill building, allowing people to develop the skills to better manage their life. And so we actually think it's something that we should all do and that we would all benefit from, and that in fact it is preventive enough. So if we think about the importance of early intervention, that's where it comes from. With CBT Associates, I started working with, speaking with organizations, talking about what we were trying to do by building a network of clinics. And without getting into the details, I will say that I was quickly put back into my seat, saying that it's difficult for me as an employer and an HR, senior HR person, to talk to my employees about a course of treatment that I don't cover for them in their benefits program. So that caused us pause, and we said, okay, if the objective here is to A, lower the cost dramatically, and to B, overcome some of those barriers of geography and stigma, frankly, then we probably need to look at technology and garner some of the benefits of that, and that's where Beacon came from. The concept of using technology and combining it with a clinical approach with the most evidence to meet the needs of this mental health crisis. I don't want to go deeply into how it works, but I would say that when we designed it, we looked around the world in the work that was being done in Australia, that was being done in the UK in different ways, and the way that they had capitalized on technology, and we thought we can do it better. What we want to do is replicate best practice in clinical care that we were doing in our clinics. So it starts with assessment, rigorous assessment. It continues with the use of a regulated mental health professional, that everybody recognizes that everybody is unique and needs a personalized care path. And so that building a platform that allows everybody to receive treatment that's right for them and their presentation was core. And that there was also a component of being able to make it available for relapse prevention. It works. And I will share with you that this is the very tip of the iceberg of what we get to look at. Because we are a platform, we are digitally driven, and we are using the validated outcome measures at every step of our treatment. It is great learning for us, for our therapists and clinical providers, and for the business partners and public health partners that we work with. This is a snapshot, an aggregate of our workplace program, showing that 80% of people have a benefit from the program, 64% clinically significant symptom reduction, and they're happy with the platform. We can get much deeper into the data. Interestingly, our highest responding group is the moderately severe group, which goes against some of the research that's out there, or expands on it. Meaning that it is not just an approach that works with mild to moderately severe individuals. Finally, I would say that the public, well, I would say the private sector is led with companies and with the carriers in Canada that are looking for a mental health solution. We have with our team very much much kept the public sector abreast of what we were doing. In fact, encouraged them to review this new approach earlier this year. Both HQO in Ontario and TCAF came out with recommendations that this should be publicly funded. So that is something we are very, very happy about. So finally, I'm going to share a 1 minute video. So I'm going to go 40 seconds over, but it gives you a sense of testimonials that come from